Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Let's Play Starcraft 2 Legacy of the Void. As always, I'm PA. Now, let's go ahead and go get this guy in control of his people. Unfortunately. Or I could go here, but no, I made a promise.
It brings me great joy that the Purifiers have chosen to join the Daylam. But there is still the matter of the Tal'darim. Siding with Alarak is indeed a risk.
Oh wait, we already heard this a couple episodes ago. He basically said, there's not a choice. We gotta do it.
It is an armada. Behold the Death Fleet under Amon's command, poised on laying waste to all life in the sector. Then we had best act swiftly. Rak'Shir. Usurpation by ritual combat cannot be rushed. Its rites demand careful preparations if they are to be accepted.
We are in orbit above a hostile world with an imposing fleet, and you speak of preparation?
I intend to depose Malash, the ruler of an entire people, and bring them under my thrall. You will aid me, and in return, I will remove the Tal'darim from this conflict. That was our bargain. To do this, the ritual must be carried out as tradition demands.
This bargain grows less appealing by the moment.
All right, more conversations.
I wish to know more about this Rak'Shir. Your ritual combat.
To understand Rak'Shir, you must first understand the sacred chain of ascension that ultimately links to Amon. Each of us is shackled to his will, and to the will of he who is in the link above. And yet, there is a way to ascend. By blade and blood, any Tal'darim can usurp the position of the one above his station. It is through this ritual that Amon's ascendants are assured to be the most capable to carry out his will.
Then Malash is the most powerful of your people?
He is considered so, but he has yet to face me.
What if he fails? I mean, he won't.
Our scouts are reporting the Dominion is attempting to fight back the Golden Armada. Despite their efforts, multiple systems have fallen.
There are things I understand about the Tal'darim. Their zeal, their desire to appease their god. What I cannot understand is why Amon would cast aside his loyal allies so easily. Why he would betray their sacred trust and treat them as fodder.
I have felt his grand ambitions, Artanis. The dark truth is, Amon wishes no allies aside from his hybrid. He believes he's ending a cycle of violence, but he only brings about an eternity of abomination.
Okay. What do you guys say, Karax?
I've been analyzing the Tal'darim's war machines. Their technology is cloned from Kalai designs. Aside from the construction materials, there is little deviation. How is this feat possible?
There have always been legends of vessels that set out into the cosmos and never returned. Of attack forces gone missing.
I have heard these stories. Whispers of angry spirits of our past that strike when you are most vulnerable. Imagine if all this time we have been fighting an unknown war against the Tal'darim.
It would explain a great deal.
How sad. They are thieves, never knowing the joys of their own invention. How despicable.
Alrighty, I think that's it. Let's go beat some folks up.
Invoke the challenge of Rak'Shir, preparations must be completed, as the decrees of old describe. Ready your warriors. Malash will surely attempt to interfere.
Kill one of Malash's guardians while the Terezin fog is active. Complete the steps of the right mission before the fourth Terezin fog cycle begins. Sure, why not? So defeat it before the fourth thing goes on and kill one of the things during one of the things. I'm sure there's nothing that could possibly go wrong.
These are Malash's guardians. I need you to eliminate them before I proceed.
If it must be done. Wait, what is that strange fog?
Tarazine. It flows in cycles from the chasms of slain, bringing us closer to the void. Amon's forces will be able to manifest until the flow subsides. They do not possess their full power here, yet they will strike at your base ruthlessly.
I thought you promised an assured victory, Alarak.
You enjoy a challenge, do you not?
Very well. My forces will pursue the Guardians while it is clear. When the Terezin flows, we must endure the onslaught.
Okay, let's get going.
The Terezin will rise shortly, my warriors. Be vigilant.
Void rays can now be warped in at our Stargate. They are ideal for intercepting foes in the battle ahead.
Well done, Faysmith. We will make good use of them.
Okay, fine. Oh, I see. Well, let's get a bunch of minerals first, and then I'll get working on the Vespine. Oh, here. You. Go grab that. I'm gonna turn home.
The veil between this world and the void is lifting. Amon's forces will arrive soon. Come on.
Cold is.
All right. Was that it? Or. Oh my god, it's Creep. I have effectively duplicated Zerg Creep, but for the Protoss. I don't know why I didn't see that before now. Still, that's really funny, actually. It actually encourages, like, laying down a series of pylons. Okay, three of you. Onto this.
We are one with the shadows. Upgrade.
Whoa! Okay. Intriguing. I guess the Void Rays were still at full tilt. But, still. Okay, so I gotta kill them all before the fourth fog cycle.
Kill them slowly and painfully.
My people will fight with honor, even when we are fighting for you. But first, we must establish our defenses.
Okay, let's get going.
Cold is the void. Veraku.
Okay.
Hierarch, I was able to scan the Tal'darim motherships in this region. They are carrying shipments of solarite. I don't think Alarak would mind if we liberated them.
Okay, fog arrives in 3 minutes. Let's load this guy to nearly no HP.
Come to bear witness to the end.
And leave him. We'll come back for that guy later.
I serve for now.
Tal'darim mothership? Oh, void rays. It's telling me to use void rays. I see. Sure, build a lot of units, and build a cybernetics core while we're at it, because I don't think I have one of those yet, and I need it for upgrades. Let's build an immortal. We can get Colossus eventually, but for now, not super necessary. You three, on there. Zealots, yes please. We could warp in a dark. We could warp. Warp. We could warp one in. Don't you know?
You require more vespine gas.
Yeah, yeah, I know. Okay, void rays. Let's go. I mean, the fact that the one ability can... What is... Oh! I see, I can get there on foot. Well, time to do so. Let's get the movement speed bonus here and get going.
Very well. Intriguing. Veraku.
The fog gathers, Artanis. Make your preparations if you're so inclined.
I have no idea what that ability was, but sure.
We have destroyed a Tal'darim mothership.
Excellent. Only one remains.
Our pylon is under attack.
I return.
Your power is greater than you believed, Firstborn.
This shall not be our end, but a new beginning.
Mass recall. Okay, we got him. Easy. Too easy.
Very well.
Boosh. Done. Okay, let's upgrade ground armor. Let's upgrade air weapons. Let's warp in a couple of void rays. You will also be in here. In fact, let's just build the robotics bay. Wow. Thors. Really? I mean, they're weak. Versions of Thor's, but still, dick move. So I've got to kill all the dudes before the fourth cycle of this, huh? Alright. Let's make a couple more warp gates.
Our pylon is under attack.
Which one? Oh no! The one I don't care about.
The parazine fumes are gone. Continue your hunt, Artanis.
Okay, let's go. And you, get back to work. What are you doing there?
The strength of the chosen.
Wow. Can't believe they...
Tal'darim ships are heading towards our Nexus, Hierarch.
Are they now?
Bring them down.
Yeah, pretty much my thought exactly. Okay, cool. Let's go for the next one. In fact, let's just... Okay, so it is a long AoE. Let's go! Heck yeah. Got him.
You should have everything now, Faysmith.
Thank you, Hierarch. I shudder to think of what they were planning to do with it.
Okay, let's warp in a couple of units, mostly stalkers. And then let's warp in a few void rays. Really? Construct additional pylons. Construct pylons. Man, it's like that's all you got to say. Anyway, I'll just recall my army. When the time comes to do so. In the meantime, let's head out for more of these guys. I still have a minute and 11 till fog arrives, so easy. In fact, let's just warp in more reinforcements right here. Give my guys a movement and attack speed bonus. Were there anyone who were more blatantly evil?
Do you sense it, Tal'darim? Shame you have no time to enjoy it with Amon's forces coming after you.
Okay, let's just recall this group and guard the base. My pylons, I need those to do extra damage. Hey, what did I literally just say?
You require my skills.
Seconds until it subsides, and I should just be able to go stomp everything else in the way. Oh no, altruists! Whatever will I do? Oh, I know literally anything.
You must construct additional pylons. You must construct additional pylons.
Really? Oh, hey, zealots. Go get them, boys.
Fog is fading. What better time is there to slay my enemies?
Intriguing.
Boy, howdy, do I wish I didn't have to serve this guy for this mission, but whatever.
As you say.
If it's gotta happen, it's gotta happen. Yeah, okay, never mind. I'm siding with the guy who didn't just say that.
Enemy ships have set a course for our nexus.
You will stand against a god?
Yep.
Oh, what glorious deaths. You do well to promote my cause, Artanas.
I only hope that is true.
I am the voice of the Eclipse.
Oh, it's actually... it's a warp prism. So I need to go kill it. Got it. Very good well. Times. That was not that guy's brightest move.
Intriguing. Very well.
Okay. Before the fourth Terra's fog cycle. So I just gotta kill it before that shows up. Easy. Luckily, my Void Rays are all up to full tilt thanks to the exceedingly high number of high health things in the area. Yep, yours. Alrighty. Oh, he didn't explode.
Heard enough of his lies.
Huh. Okay, he actually killed the last guy himself is the reason.
The ritual is complete. What now? Well, they were not part of the ritual, but these traitors would have aided Melash in it, and I wish to see them die. Now the time has come. High Lord, hear me. I invoke the right of Rak'Shir. Fight me according to our laws, or die a coward.
We meet in combat at daybreak. You shall have your challenge.
All right, cool. Got Void Rays, your new faction specialization available. Tal'darim. Okay.
I am going to make this clear. The Templar are not a weapon you can wield as you wish. We are not here to slay your enemies under false pretenses. Deceive me again, and this alliance of ours comes to an end.
Slaying Melash's guardians fulfilled more than one purpose. Once the High Lord lies dead at my feet, none will challenge my rule.
What was that orb?
After all these years, my victory is nearly at hand. I feel his concern, Artanis. He knows that I'm coming for him.
Melash?
No. Amon. Through the breath of creation, I peer beyond the veil. Oh, yes, I feel his rage washing over me. He knows I no longer fear him. He knows that the Tal'darim have no collar for him to control. I will turn the Chosen against him.
Do not assume you are already victorious, Alarak. Do not let the Terezin cloud your judgment. You have a battle to win first.
The battle is already won. In my mind's eye, I have delivered the killing blow in a thousand ways.
From my experience, overconfidence is your opponent's greatest ally. Do not let yours aid Melash.
Spoken as one who welcomes defeat.
Hierarch, one of our combat units can be assigned a new faction through the console in the War Council.
Alright, you still high, or...?
Melash has proven himself to be a dangerous leader.
Indeed. That's why my victory shall be the sweetest of ecstasy.
Has he defeated many in this rite?
Countless. He ascended the chain with brutal wrath, plowing through all who opposed him. It's as if he were blessed by the Dark God. They called him the Blade of Amon.
And still he was challenged?
It is our way. He defeated each with lingering cruelty. Melash revels in bringing his challengers to the edge of death and tormenting them for a time after.
That does not comfort me, Alarak.
Comfort is a myth. Given to younglings until they are ready for the trials and pain that is true existence. Leave me. It is time to make preparations.
Alright, whatever you say, bub.
This chain of ascension is a despicable practice.
Seconded.
It is how the Kalai once thought of the Narazim's shadow walk.
There is no comparison. Our society was not founded upon...
Their culture is one unyielding hierarchy. Servant to master. A constant reinforcement of their bondage to Amon. But they have been lied to, Matriarch.
And how could this change if it is all they have ever known?
Our people once only knew hatred of one another. Suspicion.
Yes.
We viewed your practices as barbaric, and you viewed ours as cruel. It is the same with the Tal'darim, with the destruction of Amon, and the revelation of his betrayal. I expect their entire society to seek out who they truly are, and what they wish to be.
That's pretty optimistic, but sure, we'll roll with it.
The assault ships are now ready for your inspection.
Assault ships? Oh, Void Ray or Destroyer. Okay, and... Okay, so it just chains damage to other units. I mean, that's pretty cool looking, don't get me wrong. But Void Ray's focus damage in enough quantity is probably better, because if these are only attacking one unit, well, that's it. They just have normal things. So these are for crowds, but usually crowds aren't my problem. It's very big things that are my problem. So yeah, Void Ray. Oh, it also increases the range. Yeah, no, Void Rays are better.
Kerax, the Keystone, it's...
reacting. To void energies upon the planet's surface, most likely. I've seen this before on Ulnar. This Terrazine must be directly linked to the void.
The Tal'darim call it the breath of creation. They believe imbibing it allows them to speak directly to Amon.
A far-fetched claim, yet I cannot deny its plausibility. The substance's properties appear to be foreign to our universe.
Perhaps this is why it is so holy to them. They seek out planets rich in Terrazine and turn them into temples to their god.
Our coming here may be a blessing to us. If the Keystone reacts to Terrazine like it does with void energy, I may be able to use it to stress the artifact, determine its limits.
Perhaps fate has not abandoned us completely. We must have faith.
I prefer results, Hierarch. Amon is powerful in measures that eclipse even the Queen of Blades. There is no room for uncertainty.
Alright, and what do we got for the core? We've got more solarite, 25 actually. So I could go back to Temporal Field and upgrade to... Mass Recall's been actually super useful, sorry Phoenix. But Phoenix attacks on his own, okay. I actually really like the Matrix Overload. It's been pretty handy. More handy than I thought, especially with warp in reinforcements. Warp harmonization is still super useful. Yeah, no, I think this is actually my best setup. I'll save my remaining Solarite for over here. And who knows, maybe eventually there'll be an upgrade that I'll want to switch to a set of upgrades that can break the game over its knee.
Let Rak'Shir commence!
Death Fleet active. That's not comforting. Tal'darim High Lord sighted. Also not comforting. Support Alarak with 25 units or more at the same time. Destroy 3 Tal'darim Nexuses. Okay, so I can support him with units, and I can throw Nexuses into the mix. Sounds good to me, sure. That is a cool picture, though. Pressing any key to continue in 3, 2, 1.
The rite of Rak'Shir has begun. From this moment, only Alarak and Malash are allowed to engage each other in combat directly. One must overpower the other and reach the pit of sacrifice. There... the victor will stand as the new leader of the Tal'darim,
and the loser's life will be forfeit.
They appear quite evenly matched.
This is true. However, from what I have learned, Rak'Shir allows the champion's supplicants to support them psionically.
Our warriors will be able to aid Alarak, but likewise, the Tal'darim can assist Malash.
I will ready our forces. Malash will fight ruthlessly to hold on to his power. We must be prepared to do the same.
Tal'darim will send warriors to aid Malash shortly. We should ensure Alarak has sufficient reinforcements.
Malash is drawing power from the Tal'darim. Alarak will need the support of our warriors.
I serve for now. For the reckoning.
Yes, your psionic power courses through me. Move forward, slaves! Kill all who aid Malash!
You would do well to remember that I command these warriors, Alarak, not you.
Alrighty. Art of War. Oh, I get it. Anyway. I should put at least two on there to start. I can start upgrading air weapons, but I don't want to do that yet. I want to build a forge, and early. Evenly matched? What? I'm supporting it with like, seven dudes. Now more than seven. Here, build a pylon or two. And I'll upgrade ground weapons when I have enough. I need to put one more probe on this assimilator. Wait a second.
Understand how this is possible, but my scanners are detecting high solarite concentrations in the native beasts here.
We ought to pursue them. However, I think it's best if we don't inform Alarak of this little diversion.
Understood, Hierarch.
Okay.
It would be wise for us to build a second nexus here.
Really? You think so? Okay, sure, whatever. We'll do it. I haven't even maxed out production on the first one, but we'll do it. I should go defeat that elemental here in a bit. Whoa! How did he push forward so much? I wasn't paying attention. I don't want him to push forward too much, so I'm gonna let him hold there for the time being. Alright, so we have to go beat up the native fauna, which apparently has solarite in it, cause sure, the power of the sun inside a local beast, because we need it. Don't worry, I'll just recall these guys once I'm done. Okay, got it.
Warriors, the first beast has been slain.
Unseen.
sensing hybrid. They come to aid Malash.
Amon's harbingers, join our struggle. Fight well, warriors, and you will also ascend into hybrid.
Oh, you lie with such conviction. It is almost admirable. My vengeance will
okay.
be delayed. Send me your warriors.
Locking on to the beast's coordinates.
I'm on it, I'm on it.
Warping it aboard.
Chill, I'm on my way.
I cannot wait forever, Arcanus. I must have more power.
Chill, I'm here, you're fine. That's why chronostasis is useful. There we go. Get owned, bub. Okay, let's go get the next guy. Keep producing probes. They're currently evenly matched, apparently, so I'm not too worried about it. And if I ever get attacked, I can always just recall if I need to. Void Ray's providing great support for the time being. I like it. Don't have any other stargates, but two is really all I've needed.
Our pylon is under attack. You must construct additional pylons.
Oh, come on, seriously?
Now I have
Don't make me recall.
My preliminary scans indicate that the solarite deposits are a byproduct. The beast's unusual digestive system.
Are you saying that they're... Wait. Never mind. I do not wish to know.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not gonna ask either. That's fine. Nope, perfectly fine. Not knowing. It's me, the person who's perfectly fine not knowing the answer to that question. Okay, good times. Oh, I'm not too worried about them. Our army is pretty solid right now. Worth a stasis? Probably not. Maybe it was. Now it's worth a stasis. Oh, for the love of... There. And one more to make it an even 200.
Lash. I will lead them.
Too late. He's already lost. Into the pit.
Tal'darim, by the right of Rak'Shir, I am your High Lord. Listen and obey. Malash promised you lies. There is no ascension. The Tal'darim will never be uplifted and become hybrid. Amon betrayed us. And for this, he must die.
I appreciate that everybody in the audience is super hyped about that. 250 solar power, let's go. What didn't I do? I destroyed 3 nexuses. Whatever. That mission was actually pretty quick. We might have time for one more. Unless there are a ton of cutscenes. And that is very possible.
What they believe is of little consequence. What matters is that they obey.
You choose to rule differently than I, Alarak. Despite this, we may not only end the violence between our kind, but forge a powerful alliance.
Can we now? My people are vastly different than yours, Hierarch.
We both desire vengeance, and we are both Protoss. Is that not enough?
Very well. Submit to my absolute authority, and we may indeed unite our forces.
Do not test me,
Tal'darim.
Amon is a mighty foe. Your people cannot hope to stand alone against him. You will side with me, and together we will send him back to the abyss.
So you do understand my culture after all. Let us save it for now. We have struck another bargain.
Hierarch, I have powered up a new ship subsystem. You can review it in the solar core now.
Have the Tal'darim accepted the truth of Amon's betrayal?
Some have. Others dare not question my commands.
None wish to declare Rak'Shir upon you.
Let them. No one can stand in the way of my vengeance. This grows tiring. We have done what we came to do. Set course for Ire, and let us bring this war to Amon.
Do not dare give me orders, Alarak. We will return to Ire only when I believe the time is right.
Let's hope that time comes soon.
Alrighty, what else have we got? Ah, lots of new conversations.
Artanis. You should know my fear of the Tal'darim is not of them now, but what becomes of them if Amon is defeated.
You fear they will never integrate with our society.
They share our blood, but they are not like us. You know in your heart that may never change.
It is true. A great battle may loom on the horizon ahead of us, but it's a risk we must take.
It is a great risk.
The dawn of a unified Protoss requires much. Like the threads of a cloth, we must come together and be stronger because of it.
To think what we'd become with their culture influencing us, changing us.
Yes, we will be changed. And perhaps that is what you fear more than battle. The path ahead is uncharted, Matriarch.
Alrighty, what do you think?
Rohana.
I can see it, Artanis. The truth Amon wishes to hide. While his brethren, the Xel'naga, slumber through the millennia, Amon and his followers descended upon Ire.
And he uplifted our people. They ruled over us as teachers, as gods.
He changed us, manipulated our essence. But we grew beyond his control. He and his followers fled to Xeris to create the Zerg. The hybrid are the culmination of his efforts. False Xel'naga, created in his image. We must...
Rohanna, this is too dangerous. You cannot go on like this.
I must, Hierarch. It is my duty to know the truth, to bear it. I know now. This is my purpose.
All right. The Terrans still don't quite fit into any of this, though. Like, in the grand scheme of things, they were just kind of there. Like, is that the thing that allowed us to kind of finally beat the odds? Is the fact that there was someone besides Essence of Purity or Purity of Essence or Purity of Form hanging around?
Tal'darim Wrathwalker robotics are now online, Hierarch.
Wrathwalker. Okay, so they're Colossus, but they're single target. Oh, they can also attack ground and air units. Can attack while moving. Oh yeah, but the regular Colossus can do that too. So yeah, I think I'll stick with Colossus. Lighting enemy things on fire. Pretty good, actually. The last thing I have to get is carriers. Oh wait, what didn't I look at?
Alarak has brought his ascendants into our fold. They are fierce, but strong.
Oh, new High Templar.
Vengeance for the betrayed.
What? Sacrifice reduces target friendly unit to one life, grants the ascended 2 energy for each life point reduced. Well. Oh, hello! How are you doing? Good to see you here. What's in the solar core?
The solar core is functioning perfectly, Hierarch.
Perfect.
Do not think what has happened here will spare Alarak from my watchful eye. I did not expect it to. If he dares to betray us or takes any action against you, I promise his blood will coat these corridors.
Good. That is what I am counting on.
Alrighty, and do we have enough to do the 100?
80.
Oh, right, we have Purifier Beam. Time Stop. Energy cost 0 for all of these. Bombards the target area for 15 seconds, firing 200 random shots. Okay then. Yeah, sure. See, this would automatically heal my stalkers, though. And my sentries. It's really good. I think I have to. Yeah. It's too good. And then the Purifier Beam. Cause yeah. Purifier Beam. Holy shit. Alrighty. I think unfortunately that's gonna have to be it for this episode, cause we are gonna go to another planet in a minute here. But let's just check what's going on there real quick.
Overseeing Amon's hybrid production lab. I will not let this continue. We will go to Revanskar and destroy the station before Amon can create more of these abominations.
Sounds like a plan. Next time on Starcraft 2 Legacy of the Void. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll see you in the next episode.